Η Αγία Ελένη, η μητέρα του, ανεκάλυψε τον Τίμιο Σταυρό στα Ιεροσόλυμα, ο οποίος είχε χαθεί μετά τη Σταύρωση. Έψαξε, έσκαψα και τον βρήκα. Επομένως, οι δύο αυτοί Άγιοι μας προβάλλουν τον Σταυρό σήμερα σε αυτή την τελετή αποφυτίσεως. Το Σταυρό που είναι σύμβολο νίκης, σύμβολο ελευθερίας, σύμβολο σωτήριας. Ο Μέγας Κωνσταντίνος είναι σύμβολο και για κάτι άλλο. Είχε την τόλμη, είχε το φοβερό θάρρος να πάρει την πρωτεύουσα του κράτους από τη Ρώμη, ύστερα από αιώνες που ήταν εκεί, και να την πάει στην Ανατολή. Όχι σε κάτι που υπήρχε, δεν υπήρχε τίποτα. Απλώς ξεκίνησε από το μηδέν για να κάνει την Κωνσταντινούπολη ως πρωτεύουσα πλέον του Ρωμαϊκού κράτους. Let me say it also in English. Saint Constantine had the courage, the boldness, the tremendous power to transfer the historic Rome, capital of the Roman Empire for centuries, to an otherwise unknown place, which was a colony of some people from a small village in Greece called Megara. Remember, Saint Constantine didn't have helicopters or airplanes to fly around and find a better place for a new capital. It was a genius that he discovered the place. Strategically located, connecting between Europe and Asia, combining sea, land, in a way that would make the city just the best place, extremely strong, very beautiful, but it was a daring, very daring. My beloved graduates, you are not invited to change the capital or any location, but you are invited to do daring, bold, courageous things in life. If Constantine stayed in Rome, it would be one of the, I don't know how many Roman empires, emperors. What he did make him the great Constantine. Saint Constantine did something else. I don't know why I'm aware of that. He was the one who convened, technically speaking, the first ecumenical council. The very central institution, which is the ecumenical council, central in Orthodox Church, started with Saint Constantine in the year, as you know, 325. Constantinople was not yet inaugurated that city. It happened a few years later. Therefore, the first ecumenical council convened in Nicaea, but that was the first. Can you imagine creating this kind of institution for the first time? And that was not a local event, as you know from your church history courses. The participants in the Nicaea first ecumenical council came from as far as Cordoba, Spain, at that time. A trip that necessitated months. That's why we know that some of the hierarchs that were on their way to participate in the council died on their way there because of the difficulties of traveling. So it was a terrific achievement to have a first ecumenical council. Saint Constantine. In other words, living in a condition as graduates, especially the people from you that will become priests, in addition to the already clergy of this graduating class, beloved and respected hierarchs, it's a record today that we have 9 already